Welcome to Python with Andrew, and today we're going to start our journey looking at Python functions. We'll start with the basics. Functions are one of the most powerful parts of any programming language, not just Python, any programming language. In fact, if you go further down the path of learning coding or learning Python, you will write lots and lots and lots of functions, so we need to get good at it. I'm going to start with the basics because I do find that although I think functions are very powerful and very simple, if you jump in and look at all of it at once, it gets a bit complex on which is a parameter, which is an argument, and all these sort of questions. So I'm going to take it one step at a time and also look at the different uses when we talk about functions. So I've called today's topic, Let's Hide the Detail. So let's use functions to hide the detail. And we're going to look at both functions we've already used, but also let's write a function and see what happens when we use it. So let's jump over to the code. So Python functions, very, very easy to use, but they're also very, very powerful. Now we have used lots and lots of functions already. In fact, the simplest one that we've used a lot is print hello everyone. And if I run that, that does exactly what we've been, let me save that, clear that again and run that. And we get hello everyone. If I run it again, the same. If I keep running that, I'm going to get the same, if you like, message. In fact, if I create another print statement, hello, well, I said goodbye everyone. Bye everyone. And run that, clear that, and run it. It does exactly the same. I've called the same function called print with different arguments. They're called arguments. And I get a different result, but there's a different, it's the same function. Now, I said, let's hide the detail. Here's a good example. We don't know how the print function works. We haven't seen the code for the print function. And most of us don't care. Someone has written the code for the print function and that's hidden. We don't need to see it. We don't want to see it. We don't care. All we know is that if we put in one string or two strings, et cetera, then we get an answer. We also know if we put a variable, we get an answer and it's always on the screen. So that's a really good example where the function has been written. The detail of the function's been hidden. It's been published so we can use it. It's part of the standard Python and every other language. So we can use it as much as we like. But underneath it, it could be very complex. It could be 10 lines of code, could be 20, could be 50 lines of code. We don't know, we don't care. So that's what I mean by hiding the detail. Functions are really good when we want to, if you like, do all the work and then hide it and let it make it easy for someone to use. And that's the case here. Now, just to give you an example of, if you like, what you can do with the print, as soon as I do that, you can see in my editor, it pops up all the options I've got, all the different arguments I've got and how it's going to work, et cetera. So it's quite complex. I don't care about the detail at this moment, but it's quite detailed. And we could use it in a lot of different ways. So far, we've been using it by, putting one or two strings or integers in there, and it's fine. So that's the print function. Let me delete that. So how do we go about defining a function and define a function where we're going to hide the detail? Well, step one is I'm going to create a simple function that prints out something, right? It takes no arguments and it doesn't return anything. It's just very, very simple. But let's do it. Simple, and I'm going to call it introduction, open bracket, close bracket, and then semicolon. That's the format. It's got the define or DEF. It's got the function name, which can be mostly anything, like our variable names. It's got an open bracket and a closed bracket, and it's got a semicolon, okay? And then indented must be my define my function. And my function is going to say, hello, everyone. That's my introduction. Okay. And that's the end of my function. Very simple function. As you can see, by indenting it, we know that the all the code belongs to that function. It's got no arguments here. It returns nothing. So it's very simple, but it does hide whatever the introduction is. So, of course, if I run this now, nothing will happen. All right. Oops, I lied there. I close it. If I save it and I run it, nothing happens. Why? Because at this stage, we're not calling the function. But now down here in my main program down the bottom, if I call introduction, I need to call it with the function name and the brackets to show that it's a function. Now, if I call this, it'll do the introduction. Great, nice and easy. Now, notice I've got no string here, so I haven't got any arguments that I'm passing through. And up here, I haven't defined any parameters, so I'll keep flipping between that terminology. You call with arguments, you define with parameters. We'll introduce that in another video. Now, of course, this is not hidden from anyone, but I could hide this in another module and just let you use it. Equally, I could change this function here, hello to everyone today. And if I do that, of course, and then run it, I get my change function. So this is my main program. I haven't changed my main program. Very basic, I know, but I have changed, if you like, the function definition. That's all there is to it. You have a def, you have a function name, open and close brackets, colon, don't forget the colon, I always do. Then indented, you have the code. And then later on, you can call the function. Now, I always have a habit to say, I think good practice is define all your functions first, then use them at the end, or use the ones that have already been defined earlier. Some languages force you to do that, others don't. But I think it's good practice to define the function and then use it later. So we're going to build on this and then look at other aspects of functions bit by bit by bit. But my view is you should practice just using the basic functions, even if they don't seem to do much. It's a good habit to form, because I would suggest that if you go into programming, 80, 90, maybe 95% of your programming will be in functions, creating functions. That's how powerful they are. So do practice and do get used to it. And the last thing I'll say, we've only got one line in this function. I could have made it much more complex, and I will in the future. Okay. So that's all there is for today's lesson on functions, or the basics. We're using it to hide the code in this case. Thanks again, and hope you enjoyed it. Have a great day.